2.1b, Prime Factorization, Divisibility Tests. A number is divisible by a smaller number if the smaller number evenly divides into the number. There are a few tests that we can use to help us find three numbers that are commonly found in a larger number. This is 2, 3, and 5. There are divisibility tests that go with each of these. To decide if a number is divisible by 2, the last digit is even. This means the last digit of the number needs to be a 0, a 2, 4, 6, or 8. For it to be divisible by 3, the sum of the digits divides by 3. For it to be divisible by 5, the last digit needs to be a 5 or a 0. Finally, for any number larger than these, such as 7, 11, 13, 17, or 19, we need to use long division. Let's see how this works in example 1. Example 1 asks, 2,730 is divisible by which prime numbers? This means we need to find all of the prime numbers that divide into this number. Let's start by looking back at our divisibility tests. The first divisibility test sees if a 2 will divide into this. Remember, the number must be even. If we look at the number, it ends in a 0. 0 is even, so we know that 2 divides into 2,730. Next, we determine if 3 divides into this number. To do so, we determine if the sum of these numbers will divide by 3. What this means is you add up each of the numbers, or 2 plus 7 plus 3 plus 0. 2 plus 7 is 9, 9 plus 3 is 12, and since 12 divides by 3, the entire number divides by 3. Next, we determine if 5 divides into this number. Remember, for 5 to divide into the number, the last digit needs to be a 5 or a 0. Since the last digit is a 0, we know that 5 divides in. We now need to determine if we have found all of the numbers. To do so, let's start by dividing each of the numbers we've already found into this number. Let's start with 2. 2 divides into 2,730. 2 goes into 2 once with 0, bring down the 7. 2 goes into 7 3 times, which gives us 6. 2 goes into 13 6 times, which gives us 12. And 2 goes into 10 5 times, which gives us the 10. Now let's divide 3 in. 3 goes into 13, 65. As you can see, I've moved the number that was remaining into the inside. 3 goes into 13 4 times. 3 goes into 16 5 times. And 3 goes into 15 5 times. Now we can try our 5. 5 goes into 455. 5 goes into 45 9 times. And 5 goes into 5 once. As you can see, we have 91. We need to know if there's any other numbers that are going to divide into this. Remember, for any numbers that were above 5, such as the 7, 11, 13, 17, and 19, we needed to use long division. Let's start with the 7. 7 goes into 91. 7 goes into 9 once, leaving us with 21. 7 goes into 21 3 times, giving us 21. and no remainder. We can now see that we have found prime numbers. We have found that there's a 2, a 3, a 5, a 7, and a 13. These are all of the prime numbers that divide into 2,730. So this is our final answer. Let's see the same type of problem in example 2. Example 2 asks, 133 is divisible by which numbers? Well, let's look at our divisibility test first. If it's divisible by 2, then the last digit needs to be even. Is the last digit even? No. It is a 3, therefore it is not divisible by 2. Next, we need to know if the sum is divisible by 3 to see if the whole number is divisible by 3. 1 plus 3 plus 3 gives us 7. 7 is not divisible by 3, therefore the whole number is not divisible by 3. Next, we decide if it's divisible by 5, remembering that it needs to end in a 0 or a 5. This ends in a 3, so the number is not divisible by 5. This means we need to use long division. Let's start with the 7. 7 goes into 133. 7 goes into 13 one time, giving us 7. This gives us a 6 and a 3. 7 goes into 63 9 times, giving us 63. We now have two prime numbers, both the 7 and the 19. Since they're both prime numbers, this is as far as we can go. And this means that 133 is divisible by the prime numbers 7 and 19. This is our final answer. Remember, when doing prime factorization, that you need to know your divisibility tests. It's divisible by 2 if the last digit divides by 2, or in other words, if it is even. Also, it is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits divides by 3. It is divisible by 5 if the last digit is a 5 or a 0. And finally, for any prime number that is higher than 5, such as 7, 11, 13, 19, they all must use long division.